I studied estuaries for my PhD. I deeply love them. I find them fascinating and I find them beautiful. Normally they're kind of quite difficult to appreciate, but I'm here at Southend where there's a 2 kilometer pier, and that means you can see them from above, which makes them really interesting. So estuaries are created where a river joins the sea, in this case the River Thames, and I view it as a sort of a play in two acts with two performances a day, high tide and low tide. So act one, at high tide, you have the sea come up and the river backs up, but there's the nutrient that has been brought down from the river makes it nutrient rich. The sediment has been washed down, so it's muddy. And as it's muddy, it's shallow. And as it's shallow, on days like today, it will warm up and it's light. And as it's partly seawater and partly river water, it's brackish, somewhere in between the two. So the water is warm and nutrient-rich and light and brackish, which makes it perfect for the growth of microscopic plants, phytoplankton. And so this is an extremely productive system. And then the phytoplankton is eaten by microscopic animals, zooplankton. And then these phytoplankton and zooplankton are then eaten by things you can see, by molluscs and worms and shrimps. And because this system is so productive, these occur in enormously high densities. And then when the sea is in, then marine aquatic predators will move in. So fish will move up the shore, crabs will move up the shore. And these will be fed on by other species, such as cormorants and seals. They saw porpoises here a couple of days ago. And then that's the first act. The second act occurs as the tide goes out. And when this happens, the species we've talked about, the shrimps, the worms, the mollusks, stop feeding and try not to get eaten. So the mollusks, the bivalves, will clamp together their valves. The worms and shrimps will disappear down burrows. But because of this super rich food supply, you can get vast numbers of wading birds here. So I can see curlews and sanderling and brent geese feeding on the algae and oystercatchers and knot and dunlin. And these can occur in huge densities. So estuaries are a very scarce habitat really, because they only really occur in that narrow fringe between the river and the sea, along the shore, and that they're often seriously threatened because they're reclaimed for agriculture on their prime location for a range of industrial or recreational activities. So they're restricted, but where they do occur, they're often some of the most important habitats we have. So in Britain, I would say that our estuaries are one of the habitats that Britain is most famous for. So hope you appreciate stunning estuaries.